Before I get into today's video, I want to show you something. Little boys are not the only ones building their toys anymore. Check this out. A company called Goldilocks actually made that toy. They are giving girls the options to be more than just pink, fluffy princesses, fairies, and makeup gurus. So click the link in the description box below so you can get this one-of-a-kind toy for your little girl on Christmas. Now back to the video. So I was watching Scandal, and as you know, if you watch this show, Phoebe was running for president. I don't know her real name. Oh, Lisa Kudrow. I think that's her real name. So anyway, Phoebe's over here running for president. And of course, the conversation of women's stereotypes comes up because here I'm told that women cannot run the country because we are too damn emotional. So because I like to talk about my personal experiences, here are the three stereotypes that came up in that damn conversation that I had. The first one, women are not meant to speak out. See, now I can't even see how this is a thing, because first you want to sit around calling us psycho complainers, but then you're going to turn around and say that we're like mute pushovers. Clearly, whoever said that must have been referring to expected gender behavior, which is a whole nother topic. Either way, that is false.
Look, keep your fat, lazy butt in the kitchen.
Oh my God, I know this man is not talking to me like that. Like, this cannot be real life. Am I dreaming? Because this is not happening right now. Okay, relax, breathe in, breathe out, come on, you saw this out. I cannot go to jail. I will not survive in there. Just chill. Bring it down. Bring it down.
Who in the heck? You mother. Is this your suicide speech? And number two, what started the entire argument, women cannot make decisions because they are too emotional and unstable. Now, first of all, that is just plain stupid to bunch all of us women together and classify us as some crazy psychos just because of a little monthly cycle thing. I personally don't act like a beast during that time, but for the sake of argument, let's say we do. Who would you rather have making these smackdown decisions, huh? Some guy who's just cruising by, like, whatever, I don't care, let's wait it out. Or a PMSing monster who's taking no crap and is ready to lay that required smackdown at any moment. And the final one, before I had to get up and remove myself from the situation, women can't drive. Oh yes, an oldie but goodie. Seriously, okay, I've seen dudes who could barely even navigate back to the daggone entrance of life, much less drive a car, okay? And let's not even talk about not wanting to ask for directions. It's like you think that men are like these supreme beings when it comes to any kind of motor vehicle. No, I cannot tell you how many times I have seen cars parked like this. Like, wait, you got a face in my head. I dig it. And now I'm thinking what's next. But I kind of feel like I'm taking. In between the lines, jerk off. So let me know in the comments below, what are some daggone stereotypes that you have to deal with on a maybe not so daily basis, but let's go ahead and say often. Yeah, often. Don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and I will catch you guys next Monday. Peace. I'm really hard to find because she's a good girl, a good girl.